Tonight we're going to be one Rambo for hire.
Now Boris Yeltsin is in the United States for a two-week visit, and he's joining us this morning from here in New York with his interpreter, Henry Colder. Mr. Yeltsin, good morning.
Доброе утро, господин Ельцин.
Nice to have you with us.
Is somebody on with somebody? Frank, talk to me, please. He's going to go live. We cannot do another one. So tell me how to fix the audio.
Did you move?
I didn't move.
All right, we're doing that again. We're not going to sit on that same shot for 21 seconds. Go to work, Tommy. Take 7.
Tell them it is in transmission. Give me a phone. I can't stay here. I have to go back to the booth.
Hello? Morty, what happened?
They're checking.
They are checking? It takes them this long to find out? Oh, brother, heads will roll. Well, who is that? Who is that guy?
How do you do?
John Gotti's attorney, ladies and gentlemen.
That'll, of course, have to come out. Hello?
Do we have a take? Am I dismissed? You don't understand, Frank.
Want to wait for the siren? We got a siren, folks. Sorry about that. I'm sorry this is take 7, too. This is the French police are coming. This is the slowest emergency vehicle in the history of the world. Boy, I hope whoever's in that ambulance ain't very sick. And no danger of getting car sick.
Among the economy measures announced by CBS News today was an attempt to replace as many correspondents with mammals as possible. Members of the Human Correspondents Corps immediately announced it as a ridiculous idea that had no future. Eric Engberg, CBS News, Kansas City.
Oink, oink, oink.
First, Mr. Bush would accept no new taxes, then he would accept new taxes, but not... You all right? You can't do it. We cannot do it. I say, we have defective equipment here at the White House. It's only 6:25, not to worry. You want to manually zoom? You want to pick the camera up and carry it toward me slowly? We are learning how to operate our equipment here. And this is a microphone. Take 8.
Last year, Mr. Lukens, who's a Republican, was convicted of having sex with a teenager. Now he's accused of sexual harassment by a Capitol Hill elevator. Now he's accused of sexual harassment by a Capitol Hill elevator operator.
None acknowledges he may rankle some in the Senate as well as the Defense Department, and he is almost certainly right. Many on Capitol Hill... Jesus Christ. Let's try that take again.
Did you feel all the hairspray in there? It's not my fault, man. Glue won't do it. The hair's too fine. It blows.
Give me that head with hair. Long, beautiful hair. Shining, gleaming, steaming, flashing, waxing. Give me down to there. Hair, shoulder length, longer. Here, baby, there, mama. Everywhere, daddy, daddy. Hair. Blow it, show it. Long as God can do it.
All right, I can't help it, okay? Talk to the wind. It's not blowing now, and you're screwing around. Well, it'll go down, but it'll come back up. Wait a minute. I can feel the wind. Oh. Let me go back and put some more shit in my hair, but it's not going to do any good. I have to use turpentine to shampoo every morning. You know that?
You Hollywood types are all alike.
God, I love my job.
3, 2, 1, go.
Americans. We like straight talk.
If I knew where to come, I would know where to go. If I knew where to go, I'd know where to come.
We want hard facts. We demand the truth. We know who we are. And when it comes to news, we know who we trust. Dan Rather, weeknights on the CBS Evening News. We keep America on top of the world.
What is it, NBC? No.
Bye-bye.
You've been slaving in the news bureau nonstop since 8 a.m. Now, 12 hours later, the day is finally over. All you can think about is getting home. Okay, the answering machine is on, and just as you step out the door... Do you, one, turn off the lights and haul ass like you've never hauled before? Two, answer the phone. Tell the excited news director on the other end you're just a cleaning crew and don't speak a word of English. Three, answer the phone, book the crew, collect that $300 for the good of the company. That's right, you guessed it. Turn off the lights and haul ass like you've never hauled before. After all, you're not getting paid for overtime. You've been staking out the Senate's most difficult senator all morning. Your stomach's growling, your shoulders numb, and you're tired of hearing your reporter whine. Finally, you give up long enough to grab some quick lunch downstairs, and guess what? That sneaky SOB arrives while you're gone. Of course, you've missed the shot, wasted 5 hours, and blown the story. Do you, one, call the desk, admit that the lure of the Dirksen cafeteria was just too much to resist? Two, call the desk, blame it on your reporter. Three, call the desk, but tell them he must have slipped through the back door because you would never leave your post. Of course, it's three. Tell the office the senator slipped in through the back way, and what the hell, you might as well collect a meal penalty at the same time.
Please?